And it's nothing wrong with it, but like, we're wasting 30, 40 seconds walking in, walking out, the pace is really starting to slow down. All right, I'll go as slow as we need to make sure we get it. But man, we're eating up minutes. Every time it's taking us 30 seconds to get out, 40 seconds to get out, 40 seconds to get back in, we're eating up chunks of time right now. We're bringing in and out over the course of the camp 50 times. Man, we're talking about real time now, okay? So the slower you bring it in and bring it out, the less work we're gonna get in. Now, biggest thing I wanna focus on now is the double leg guy reacting, okay? Double leg guy reacting. So as I'm shooting, all right, and I feel the leg pass coming, I don't immediately bail on the double, but what I do is I got a threshold that when I start to feel that leg get across his body, I know he's beat me on the leg pass, I have to let go and start walking on my hands. It's super important, okay? So I double, he starts to whip, get to that pass. Once I start feeling my leg get straight and light, he starts to drive and roll. Here, I've got to let go, and I've got to walk, walk, walk as he's rolling right here. I want to try to stay here if I can. I'm not trying to fight this guy as we're drilling because I want him to finish and get hip down. Go ahead and finish. He's going to get hip down, and I'm going to be in this position so he can finish, all right? But I really want double leg guy. We're thinking double, finish, then he passes the leg. We got to shift gears. I've got to be just as woke looking to scramble when he's ready to go as I am when it's the other side of the coin. Offensive and defense. I can't wait till I'm halfway through a scramble position and be like, oh, this guy's scrambling on me. Oh, it's too late to do anything, okay? So again, I got that threshold. The minute he gets my leg straight and starts to pass, I'm gonna let go and float because I got plenty of options out of that. I don't worry about one little leg pass. So I double, he gets to that leg pass, I start to float here. Okay. I really want to focus on this tendency of the double leg guy walking on hands. I never go to my back here, okay? And somebody keeps asking, what happens if they just grab and hang on to the double leg? This is what happens. Nothing good. So I stay on this double leg, he starts to pass, I hang on to it. Okay, that's where we're gonna end up, if you hang on the double leg, all right? Don't want to end up there. So we're creating the tendency as I shoot and he passes, and it's time to let go and start to scramble. Okay, double leg, he starts to scramble, I float, okay? Because I got options here. I can repass, I can duck. I got ways I can beat this guy just because he passed my leg. But if we don't have that tendency to shift gears from double to continuing to scramble with this guy, we're gonna get lost, we're gonna get scored on real quick, okay? Again, we wanna beat the best guys in scrambles. Best guys in scrambles aren't saving anything for the swim back, okay? Does that make sense to everybody? So we're gonna go back out, easy doubles. Nice and slow and smooth and relaxed. The double leg guy, I want you really focused on walking on your hands. Go.